Structural level in proteins. Today, we will study the tertiary structure of protein. In the earlier class, we have studied the primary structure and the secondary structure of protein. In this lecture, we will study about the tertiary structure of proteins. As we have know that the primary structure of protein consists of the linear arrangement of amino acids. The amino acids arrange in a linear manner and forms a polypeptide chain, and this constitutes the primary structure of protein. And the main type of bond which involved in this primary structure is the peptide bond. In secondary structure, which involves the folding and coiling of the polypeptide chain, and the main type of bond is hydrogen bonding. Beside the peptide bond, the hydrogen bond plays a very important role in the secondary structure of protein. The hydrogen bond is of two types, intermolecular hydrogen bonding and the intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Now today we will study the tertiary structure of protein. What is the tertiary structure and how is it important for the protein? Let us start tertiary structure. The tertiary structure of protein is the three-dimensional conformation of the polypeptide chain. In both the primary, secondary, and also in the tertiary structure, only a single polypeptide chain is involved in the protein. And in this tertiary structure also, a single polypeptide chain forms the structure of proteins. And in this polypeptide chain acquires three-dimensional conformation. As we know that the polypeptide chain of each protein consists of a definite sequence of amino acids. And these amino acids of a polypeptide chains arrange in a definite manner and which forms a three-dimensional conformation of the proteins. Now, various types of bonding occur among the side chain or R group of these amino acids, and these bonding or interactions among the R group of the amino acid constitutes this three-dimensional structure of the amino acid. For example, this is the polypeptide chain, and there are various amino acids, and the R group of amino acids interact in various ways, and their interaction causes the bonding. Now, what are the main type of bond? The main type of bonding interactions, first one is the hydrogen bond. The hydrogen bond occur among the polar side chains of the amino acid. Second bond is the ionic bond. Ionic bond formed between the charged R group amino acid. Charged R group amino acid, some of the amino acids are acidic in nature, some of the amino acids are basic in nature. And they form bonds, ionic bond. Hydrophobic bond are formed between the amino acids having non-polar R group. And fourth and the most important bond is the disulfide bond. This disulfide bond is formed between the cysteine residues of the polypeptide chain. As we see in this structure, the two cysteine residue forms the disulfide bond. Hydrophobic interactions occur among the non-polar R group, and ionic bond is formed between the charged R group or charged side chain of the amino acid. Now these bonds are although weak bond, but hundreds or thousands of a bond when exist together, they make this three-dimensional structure very stable. To perform the biological function, the protein must exist in this three-dimensional structure. Now, the folding of the protein in this three-dimensional structure occur in such a manner that the hydrophobic non-polar amino acid exist inside the buried or deep into the interior of the folded part, while the polar side chains of the amino group exist on the outer side or exterior side of this three-dimensional structure. The function of a protein depends upon its tertiary structure. And if this tertiary structure is disrupted, the protein loses its activity. Quaternary structure. The quaternary structure exists in a protein which consists of two or more than two polypeptide chains. These polypeptide chains of a protein are referred to as a subunits. And the special arrangement of these subunits in a protein with respect to each other forms the quaternary structure of the proteins. Such proteins which have two or more than two polypeptide chains, these proteins are known as oligomeric protein. The best example of such type of proteins is hemoglobin. As we know that in hemoglobin there are four polypeptide chains are present. This is the structure of hemoglobin A. Four polypeptide chains are present in this quaternary structure, two alpha and two beta chain. Each of these polypeptide chain has a definite three-dimensional structure. हर पॉलीपेप्टाइड चेन का अपना एक पर्टिकुलर थ्री डायमेंशनल कन्फर्मेशन है एंड दीज पॉलीपेप्टाइड चेन्स आर फर्दर बॉन्डेड टू ईच अदर बाय वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ नॉन कोवलेंट इंटरेक्शन एंड दे इंटरैक्ट इन सच अ वे टू फॉर्म अ डेफिनेट क्वार्टरी स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ प्रोटीन. The hemoglobin is a tetrameric protein as four polypeptide chain are present, two alpha and two beta. The alpha chain contain about 141 amino acid residue, while the beta chain contains 146 amino acid residues. The polypeptide portion of the protein is known as the globin, and a hemigroup is present inside each polypeptide chain, and this hemigroup binds with the oxygen. Each of the four peptide chain has a characteristic tertiary structure. Thus we see that the quaternary structure of a protein exists only in those proteins which contain two or more than two polypeptide chain. Thus we see that the primary, secondary and tertiary structure of a protein exist in a molecule consists of a single polypeptide chain, while the quaternary structure of a protein exists in a molecule consists of more than polypeptide chain, and it involves the interaction of polypeptide chain within a multi-chain protein molecule. Thank you.